Hello friends, welcome back. My name is PK. In this video, you will learn how to create a stylish and dynamic comparison chart in Microsoft Excel. As you are seeing my screen, I have created this beautiful chart and this is totally dynamic chart. We can compare any metric like sales, revenue, profit or any other metrics between two time periods, 2 years or between 2 months or quarters. Here I am displaying the sales comparison between two different years, 2010 and 2011. The green arrow is just showing how much sale has been increased between these 2 years from 2010 to 2011. And if the sale is decreased for any specific product, then this back arrow will be there and on the data level we can see the number of sales decrease. I have given these option button to select. So let's say if you want to see the gap between 2 years in number, then I have selected the first option. If I want to see gap in percentage, then I will select this. Now here you can see for product 1, the sale increment from 2010 to 2011 is 45%. Similarly for product 2 is 31%, then 45%. And we can see the actual value also for 2010 and 2011 because this is just difference. So we will select this option. Now here you can see the first is just displaying 69 versus 100. 69 number was for 2010 versus 100 is for 2011. Alright friends, so this is totally dynamic chart. If I will change the year, so let's take the year here 2018 and let's take here 2019. Then we can see the comparison. The chart will be changed automatically. Now I will show you the data from where this chart is being created. So this is the data for different products. We have year wise sales and we are creating this dynamic chart using that data. Alright, now I will explain you step by step how can you create this chart in Microsoft Excel. So let's start without delay. I'm going to data sheet and I will copy this data. And I will press Ctrl N to add a new workbook. Just paste that data here. Now I will rename this sheet as data. I will add another worksheet and I will rename this as support sheet. And we will put some calculations here to create the dynamic chart. Once we will complete this chart, then we can hide this sheet. I have this support sheet here also in this workbook. If I will unhide, then you can see the support sheet is there. Now let me go to this workbook and here we will put our formulas. I will explain you all formulas. Now I'll go to this plus button and I will add another sheet which will be your chart, summary, dashboard or whatever you want to put the name. Now I'll go to the support sheet and here I will put product and we can take the product name from here. Let's select this one. And fill this down. So we have the product name. If we will make the product name change here in data, the same product name will be displayed here also. Now go to the chart worksheet. I'll create two drop downs here. Create a data validation drop down list here. So press Alt DL. Then data validation window will be opened and here I will select list. Then in the source, I'll click here and then I'll go to the data sheet and I will select these years. Just select this, click on OK. So here we have the list of years. Now we can choose any year from here. Now let's align the center and we can give some background color. Let's say this one, font color, make this white, make this bold, slightly bigger. Here we will put versus, align center, copy this and paste this here, same list. So here drop down will be available. Alright, now go to the view and remove the grid lines from here. Now go to the developer tab and then I will go to the insert and here I will insert the form control option buttons. This is the form controls. Here I will insert this option button. And just click here. The first option button I will keep for gap in numbers. So this is for gap in numbers. Make the copy of this and paste here. The second we will put for gap in percentage. Now select this one, copy and paste here. The last one we will keep for actual values. Alright, so we have three option button. Just right click on the first option button, go to the form control and cell link. Just click here, then go to the support sheet. So here in the starting columns, we will put our formula. So let's click here on N1 and just click on OK. Now, if I will select this, then you can see on N1 it is displaying 1. That means we have selected first option button. If I will select the second one and go to the support sheet, then here will be 2 because we have selected the second option button. If I will click on the third one, then here will be 3. Now on B1 and C1. So on B1 just press equal to, go to the chart. So we will take the first year whatever we have selected, just press enter. So we have selected 2016 here, so 2016 is here, or let's select 2010, then 2010 will be here. Alright, so now go to the C1 and press equal to, go to the chart and just click on F2 and press enter. So whatever we have selected on this drop down, that will come here. So let's select here 2011, so that is available here. Alright, now we will display the numbers here. So for this year, for this product, what was the sale? So I will use here VLOOKUP function, VLOOKUP. Then I will select this product 1. I'll go to the data. Then I will select this range, the entire range, wherever our data is available, comma. Then we have to provide the column index number. So we know 2010 is available on column number 2. I'll put here 2, 0 and just press enter. So it is giving me the sale for product 1 in 2010, and we can see here also product 1 2010 is 69. All right but what if I will select here, let's say 2013, then still it is displaying 69. However, in 2013 it was 88. It is because we have put here 2. Value is always taking from column number 2. So we have to make it dynamic. How we will make it dynamic? We will use here match function. So first I will show you the match function, what the match function will return. So let's say here I am using match function match, and lookup value I am taking, let's say this year, comma. Then I am going to data, you can select entire row, comma, the exact match, select this one, 0, and just close the bracket. It is returning 5. For 2013, it is returning 5. If I will select here 2010, then it should return 2, alright, because it is returning the column number where that particular year is available. So this has been dynamic. Now we can copy this formula and we can use in place of 2. Just paste this here. For this B1, press F4 so that it should not be changed when we will fill this down. And similarly for this row reference also, 1 to 1, press F4. So this is also freeze. Now if I will fill this down, then you can see it is returning the sale for 2010. If I will select here, let's say 2011, then it is returning the sale for 2011. Alright friends, here we will put the similar formula. So let's copy the entire formula and paste this here. The only change is wherever the reference is coming from this B1, just move this here and press enter and fill this down. Okay, so now let's change the year. So let's take here 2010. Here 2011, so we have the sales for different years. Alright, so now we have the sales, create some other support column. The first column we will put here is starting point. Starting point will be our whatever minimum, we will start from there. So let's take the minimum value in these two. So put the min formula and select this range, it will return whatever is the minimum value. So minimum is this 2010. And now fill this down. So here we can see for product 4, the minimum is in 2011, so it is returning 45 here. Alright. Now we will put the calculation for red arrow and green arrow. So where we should create the red arrow and where we should create the green arrow. So I will put here red arrow and green arrow. Red arrow always will be displayed when sale is higher in this year and lower in this year. That means sale is decreasing. In that case, it should display the red arrow. Similarly, green arrow should be displayed when in this year sale is higher and in this year sale is lower. So we will put the formula: if this value, which is B2, is greater than C2, that means sale was greater than in 2010 in comparison of 2011, in that case it should return V2 minus C2, else it will return NA formula, NA, and just close the bracket. So it is returning NA because in 2010 sale was lower, not the higher. If I will fill this down, then here we can see it is returning number. The difference is 36 because sale was higher in 2010 and lower in 2011. We will put the similar formula here. If, and this time we will take this value, C2 is greater than or equal to, this time we will consider the equal to also, this B2. Then put comma, we will take C2 minus V2, else we will put NA, press enter. So wherever the green arrow should be created or sale is increasing, then it will display that number, otherwise it will display NA. Now we will put the formula for data labels, because we have to display the data labels dynamically, like in percentage, number, or actual value. We will create another column for data label. Let's create the data label for option button 1 and 2, which is for gap. Okay, here I will put, if C2 is greater than or equal to B2, then I will put this plus sign because sale is increasing. Otherwise, I will put this minus sign. So in the inverted comma, we will put the minus sign or plus sign. Okay, and just close the bracket. So it will return the plus and minus only. You can see here. And then here we will put the ampersand to concatenate the plus or minus with the number. So I will use again if. Now I will take this N1. So if this value, the N1 value equal to 1, then we have to display the number. I'll use the absolute value, C minus B. Sometimes C could be bigger or sometimes B could be bigger, so it may return the negative number. So that's why we are using the absolute formula here, ABS. It will remove the negative sign from there. Okay. So this is for the 1. Else, if it is 2, then we have to display in percentage. In the else case, we can use that also. So let me copy this formula and just paste this here, and we have to divide it by B2, the base value. But this particular function may return in decimal value also. So let me put here the text function, text, and just paste this, and we will display in 0%. All right. So here you can see it is returning number in plus or minus. And if I will select here, let's say on chart, the gap in percentage, then it will display in percentage also. Your sale number also could be in decimal. So here when we use this ABS function, it may return the value in decimal. Let's say if we want to display the fixed number, then we can use here the text function. So let's use text, then we will use this ABS C2 minus B2, comma, then we will display in 0 format. Okay, so now the formula is done for these two buttons. Now we will create the formula for when the N value is 3, this one. If N value is 3, it is still displaying the same number. So what we will do, we will select this formula, cut this formula. Okay, so we will put this formula in else case. So first we will put, let's say, if this value, and press F4 to freeze this, equal to 3, then we will use text, and let's take the first value, and we will display in 0 format. We will not display any decimal number here, and then we will use AND, and here we will type, let's say, space versus, and Again, we will use text function. So text function, friends, we are using just to make it text. Otherwise, we can take it directly. So because we are giving the zero value, so let's say if this 69 is in decimal, 69.02456 or any bigger number is there. In that case, it will be helpful to create a small data label. But since it is only 69, so that's why the text function is not making any difference here. So let's use here zero. Paste that formula which we have cut already and just close the bracket. Press enter. So here you can see we have selected the third option. So it is returning the data label like this, 69 versus 69. Okay, but we have made one mistake here. That is, in this we have to take the C2, because we have taken B2 here. Now we should take C2 here. Now it is showing the 69 versus 100, and just fill this down. Alright, so our data label formula is completed. Now we will create the chart. So let's select this product column, then select these three columns, starting point, red arrow and green arrow. Go to the insert, then go to the charts, and we will go to the bar chart and we'll insert this bar chart, which is stack bar chart. Now here on the chart, first of all, what we will do, select the product, right click, go to the format axis and just scroll it down and select category in reverse order, so that product will be in sequence, whatever available here, product 1, product 2, product 3. Alright. Now the starting point, so this is the starting point. So I'll select the starting point, then I'll go to the format and I'll go to the save fill and I'll take no fill. So we have removed the starting point. Okay, now we have the red arrow and green arrow. For the red arrow and green arrow, so green arrow is this one, which is in gray, this one. Select this and then go to this plus button and here just check this error bar. So you can see for green arrow, we have the error bars here. Select the error bars, right click, go to the format error bar. Here in the format error bars, first we will select direction as minus and style as no cap. And then scroll it down and take here percentage error amount and put here 100%. Then go to the fill and line, and here we will take solid line. So this is for the green arrow. So we'll select the green color here. Let's take this light green color. Now change the arrow bit. So we will take around, let's say 2.5, this one. Scroll it down and we will change here begin arrow type. So let's take this one. And end arrow type, let's take this one. Alright, for the begin arrow size, let's take this one. Now from here, you can select green arrow. We are making the change in green arrow Y error bars. We can select series green arrow and go to the fill and say no fill. Now you can see only arrow is visible. Now just go to the series option and select the red arrow now. And this time we will add the error bar here also. So you can see the error bar are visible. You can select from here also. So let's select the red arrow by error bars. Just go to error bar option, select minus here, no cap. We will take the same option. So go to the error amount as percentage, 100%. Go to fill and line. And line we will take solid line and let's take this color, orange accent 2. Width we will take around 2.5. this one, and this time begin arrow type we will take this one, because direction of the arrow will be different. And for end arrow type we will take this one, and we will change the size of end arrow also. Let's take this one. Now from the series option, I will select series red arrow, and then in the fill I'll take no fill. Just close this. Here you can see our chart is looking like this. Select legend and just press delete. So legend will be deleted. I'll go to the grid lines and I will add all type of grid lines here, so that comparison could be easy. Now we will add the data labels. So just check the data label. Now the data labels have been added, but data label for the starting point also have been added. So we will select the data label for starting point and just press delete. So we will keep the data label for green arrow or red arrow only. So select green arrow data label, right click, go to the change data label shape and let's take this one. And now I will go to the shape outline and I'll choose this same light green color. So it will look like this. And we can make text color also the same one, this one. And go to the home and make this bold. Slightly smaller. Data label will look like this. We will select red arrow data label. Right click and change data label shape and take this one. Make the font color as this one. Make it bold. We will change the outline color also. Go to the format and take the shape outline. Let's take this one. So our chart will look like this. Now select the chart, press Ctrl X and you can paste this chart here on chart sheet. Let's keep this here. Now let's select the chart title. I don't want to show the chart title here. And I will select the chart plot area. Then I will reduce the size. To select the chart plot area, if you are not able to select from here, you can go to the format and you can select the chart plot area from here. It is selected. And now just reduce the size so that we can keep our buttons, this option buttons here. So right click and just bring them to print and keep them here. The data label is not getting changed, you can see whatever we are selecting. So what we will do, we will select first, let's say green data label. Right click, go to the format data label, and here we will select value from cells. Then we will go to the support sheet and we will select this range, which is data label column. Click on OK. Uncheck the value and show later lines from here. We will do the same thing for the red data label. Select the red data label, value from cells, then go to the support sheet. The same data label reference we will provide. OK. Uncheck the value and show later lines. So we can see gap in numbers, the positive or negative numbers are here. For the percentage are here. Actual value, the actual value also here. If I will change the selection, let's say 2011 to 12, then it will be changed accordingly. Alright friends, so friends, that is how you can create this chart. Now once you have created this chart, you can select all object together, right click and go to the group and make this group. So this is one chart now. Alright friends, I hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please hit the like button and please subscribe my channel to get the regular update of my videos. Thank you so much for watching.